We've been on a great streak, so. Oh my gosh.
Oh gosh.
Hammered,
big dude, one? Oh my god.
Giant?
I don't know. It's a good one. Dude, I was pulling. Insane. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Giant. Giant on the chug bug. Yeah, I'm gonna
like a 4.5-5.
Yeah. Oh!
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Big one, big one, net,
dude,
net,
your PB. That's your PB. That's your PB. That's your PB.
Yo, what's poppin', people? Welcome back to another video. Thank you guys so much for the support. If you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell. Also, hit the like button if you guys have been enjoying the content. Got my boy Fletcher
what's
behind the camera.
On?
If you guys want to check out his channel.
In the corner of that frame.
Yeah, I know, you're hiding back there.
I know.
What's up, Fletcher?
But today, dude, we're going to try to catch some biggins.
I know, we're going to try to catch some hogs.
Show
and,
this pawn here behind us.
Yeah,
hold up.
I got something to address to the people, Fletcher.
Okay.
Listen, I work out like my whole life. I've been working out like the last 8 years, but I'm not going to lie. The last 10 months, I haven't worked out since January 11th, really bad. Like, that's why I'm like a little puny boy right now.
You have
now.
The date on, you remember the exact date?
It's personal to me, Fletcher. Literally January 12th is when I stopped working out this year, and I have not started back since. And I'm really wanting to get back in the gym, guys. But let me tell you, I am so sore this morning. In the last episode, I caught my biggest fish of my life, and I was holding that fish up for like 10 minutes straight, and I'm actually sore from that. That just shows me. I'm like, man, I need to be back in the gym. But another thing I want to talk about, that fish was 13 pounds. We weighed it on two scales, so it has to be 13 pounds. But I started like thinking in my head, I was like, if I'm holding a 15-pound dumbbell, which is very light, very light, I'm just like thinking to myself, is that possible? You know what I mean?
But holding it straight out, you can't hold it out straight out with your arms like that too long. I know like.
Yeah, but it's like so light. Compared to that, though.
Oh, I know.
Like, I'm trying
like,
to,
like... You're trying to take a picture.
True.
You're holding that fish out for, like, 2 or 3 minutes.
True.
Taking pictures.
And I was, like, holding it up with the scale. I don't know, bro, but I was just, like, thinking about it. And it has to be 13 pounds because we weighed it on two scales.
And it's wobbling and stuff. So,
yeah. I don't know, man. It's just, it was a weird thing. And a lot of people in the comments were like, dude, that's no way that was 13 pounds. I'm like, that's what we thought, too.
Yeah.
It was just, but, I mean, heck, the scale said it, and I guess we got to go by the scale. But today, we're going for some big bass. By the way, go on Instagram right now. Start using hashtag Big Bass Energy on all your posts. I've been going through liking a lot of people's posts. Also follow me on the IG at Kicking Their Bass TV. But anyways, let's hop into the video. We're gonna be going for some bass today. More importantly, some really big bass. That's what we were trying to do in the last video, and ended up catching a catfish. So maybe our luck could be different today, and we'll catch a massive largemouth, maybe 8-9 pounds. That's what we're hoping. We're in a new little area, new little juicy
place.
Have we
fished this on your channel before?
We might have fished it briefly for like 5 minutes in an episode, but rather than that, not really. Fletcher has caught, actually, I'm not even gonna say that. Not even gonna say that, but Fletcher has caught some big ones. That's all I'm gonna say. And so we're gonna go on a hunt on this beautiful little pond right here. Let's hop right into it. Try to catch some big fish. Were you ready, Fletcher?
I'm ready, baby.
You ready?
Let's get it.
Let's get it.
All right, so we're gonna get it started by stealing one of Fletcher's chatterbaits.
That's how every video starts with
me stealing one lure a video for the next 20 years until, and then I'll just like randomly have to give Fletcher a crazy birthday gift of like a million baits. We were just talking about, I was like, dude, we need to go get our chatterbait stock up and just go buy a ton of them. This is actually the Thunder Cricket right here, which I was actually just talking about that with him. I haven't thrown it a good bit, but in the last like couple of videos, not the last couple of videos, that one where I filmed with Mike and Adam, but I was on a separate boat, I caught a few really good ones on this. And I felt different about this one until I started throwing it that day, and I caught a couple really nice fish, and I was like, you know what, I kind of like it. So we're going to try this one out. We're going to try a white one. The water clarity is pretty clear in here. Fairly clear. Fairly glossy. We're going to see if we can catch a giant. Every time I come out here and I'm just like hunting for big fish, I just want to throw a chatter donk. We were talking about that too. Like, I don't want to throw anything else but a chatter donk. The bite's just too much fun and it catches massive fish. So let's go ahead and tie this up on my rod right here and get to work. And hopefully we're just going to hook a mega today. We're ready to get it started. We have some people doing some lawn.
How do we start the show?
Every time, bro.
Without fail, man.
Somebody's doing some lawn work, but guess what? That's not gonna stop us. We're gonna start throwing this chatter donk. Fletcher said that this bank right here pretty much is a big flat and it has a good drop off. So it drops off between from 5 foot to about 10 to 12. We're gonna be staying way off of it so we can throw up on the flat and also work the drop off at the same time and see where these fish are positioned today. Since we are in the morning, these fish could be up on the shallow flat feeding on some bait fish, but at the same time, a big majority of those fish are probably gonna be on that drop off. So let's get it started. Let's start casting and let's hook a big one.
Self-talk.
Yeah. I'm gonna put on this crankbait, guys. If you want to get a 10% off discount, I'll pop it up on the screen. A little natural color 6 cents. Try something different. Oh, first cast on the crankbait. Yep, first cast. I can't tell. It doesn't feel big. First cast on the crankbait, bro. Yep, look at that.
They're large.
Little bass. This might.
Shooting down deep.
This might be a good call. I was feeling it a second ago. I was like, I'm gonna try this crankbait since we're both throwing a chatterbait until we really figure out what they want. And sure enough, nothing big, but a little fatty. Pretty markings on that bass. Always gotta get the monkey off your back. First one.
How deep does that one dive?
Dive 7 to 11 foot. Oh, they're probably stacked down there too. This might be the go.
Have you ever hooked a monster hybrid?
Not like a really, really big one. I mean, I've caught some big stripers, but.
Maybe you hooked one. Be prepared to go for a ride.
Oh, gosh.
Got one?
Yeah. That's a bass, though. I think. What is that? I knew this crankbait was going to get bit the more I threw it. This thing feels heavy. It's fighting good.
It's looking pretty good.
It's a bass.
It looks like a large mouth.
It's like a solid 2.5 pounder. God, dog, dude, he's fighting. Oh,
oh, he's
that's
chunky.
A 3 pounder. Maybe.
That's a chunky boy.
He's almost three.
It's not crazy long, but just fat, man.
Gosh. That's what we want on a crankbait. Look at that. Look at that fish.
Meatball.
Dude, that is a meatball if I know of one. That's a 2.5 pounder, easy. That might be close to three with how fat he is, dude.
Oh, I know. Good God.
And a little 2 pound body. Gosh, man. God, I can catch them all day like that on a crankbait. I'll be having a good time. Hammered it.
So there's about a million and one things to snag on out here. Be prepared.
All right. It might be stacked right here in this corner. It's fine. I got another one.
You got another one?
Yeah, they're stacked in this corner, dude. Yeah. That's what I want to get on right there. That repetitive cast of the crankbait firing them up. That one's not big. If you could just spit it, I'd rather you do that.
There you go.
Thank you for granting my wishes there, bud. Oh gosh!
Hammered, big one?
Dude, oh my God!
Giant?
I don't know. It's a good one, dude. I was insane. That was insane.
Did you hit it right next to the boat?
Yeah, I can't wait. Wait, that's a hybrid, bro.
Is it a hybrid?
Yeah, it is. That's a hybrid, dude. No wonder he's fighting so hard.
Here we go.
Fletcher was talking about this, guys. The one lake out here that's got hybrids, and that was a. This is a hybrid fighting. I could tell. But I'm gonna tell you guys something. I don't know if you know, Fletcher. You probably do since you've caught a few. You know you can't grab these on the side like a bass, right?
Oh, I know.
They got them razor blades on them.
You
so
have any scoop them for you?
Yeah, honestly. Cause I'd like to hold them up. That was freaking awesome the way he hit. Oh, that's a good one. Better than I thought, dude.
That's a decent one.
That is a decent little hybrid.
Alright
guys, so we're gonna talk about this. You guys know my background, tournament fishing. I've traveled to almost every lake you could think of in the southeast. And about these hybrids, they have these gill plates and they have a little razor blade on the side of them. So when I hold a bass by its gill plates, when it paralyzes them, that's fine. You can't do that on these because they got this little razor blade and they will cut the mess out of you. So you do have to be careful with them. Dude, I was like pulling my crankbait up to the boat. That's happened to me so many times. And he just took the rod out of my hand.
There you go. You can at least hold him like that. I didn't turn the scale on, but.
I don't know if I'm gonna weigh him.
Well, look at that. We got us a hybrid right now. Look how slimy. Why is he so slimy? Where did that just go, dude? Give you some... Look at this slime coming off.
Oh, ew.
Why is he like that?
Maybe give him hybrids a little dip.
Hybrids usually aren't like that. Fletcher was talking about it. He's like, dude, there's some big hybrids in here. And I'm like, man, you know, I'd love to catch one. I've been throwing that crankbait. I was like, they should be able to bite it. And I never had a bite. I was pulling that thing back up to the boat. Every time I get my crankbait up, I just start pulling my rod like this. And right when I went up, he just started pulling down. That is awesome. I knew when he was fighting, I was like, I don't know if this is a largemouth. But man, that's a beautiful fish. Nothing big. But I was talking about on their gill plates. I grab a bass like this, and I squeeze their gill plates because it paralyzes them. They can't move. On these hybrids, I don't know if you see that, there's two little razor blades. So you need to be careful when with these. You don't want to grab them on the side. I mean, you can, but I'm telling you, they can cut you up.
Playing with fire.
Yeah. That's a beautiful fish, man. Beautiful. Look at this, man. Catfish, now we got some hybrid action. Dude, that you can't beat that. I'd love to catch these all day, man. I would not complain. I would love catching that.
They fight so good.
They fight so hard.
Oh. Give him a little kickoff.
I'm about to say, dude. You got so much energy. Don't be playing me. That's awesome, bro. Give me a little knuckle touch.
Yes, sir.
That's cool. A hybrid in like a little pond like this. That's amazing. I've never seen that in my life. When Fletcher was telling me about it, I was like, there's no way. That's insane. Maybe we'll get us one that's like 10, 15 pounds. Look at the bait fish over there in that corner.
Ooh, see yeah, yeah. See that water? Ripple.
All right. We're going to get back in there. Let's see if we can catch a big one.
How about those are those hybrids? That's probably where that one followed me off at because I threw up there.
There's some carp that's like some small carp that's swimming around in the school in here.
Yep, it's a hybrid. Just followed me up. Yeah, dude. Almost ate me right at the boat. Those are those hybrids, dude. See, because that cast that I made, I was right here and I brought it all the way back. I'd wait before you go over this. This is right here, wasn't it? Yep.
Got one instantly?
Oh, yeah.
Decent one?
Oh, yeah.
Like neck?
I don't know, dude. He feels good, though. Yeah, he's big. He's big as crap, dude.
Net?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay.
Yeah. Hold on. He's not fighting much, but he's big. I can't even move him. Yeah, he's big, dude. I promise you, this is a really big fish. It might be a hybrid. Oh, it's a largemouth. What?
Oh.
I have him hooked weird. You see that?
Yeah.
Dang it. My bad, dude. I really thought I had him. You want to just get him in there?
Well, it's still a good fish.
Yeah. Dude, that's almost a 3-pounder.
Yeah,
look at that.
Just freaking meatballs.
Like, that is seriously almost a 3-pound fish in a 2-pound body, dude. Pretty fish, guys. Right there on the crankbait. We scanned some fish when we first came in. Look at that poopy coming out of his booty. That's a good fish. We should get a couple more to fire up.
We're actually gonna hop to another lake now. We're gonna go put it in the big lake. There's a bunch of big fish in there that can be harder to catch, but I feel good about it. We were in here for a couple of hours. We caught a good couple.
Gosh, why are you so loud, man?
Sorry, bro. Man. I don't make any noise while you're filming there, man. It would be a shame if I'd have to put this boat up all by myself.
Second. But yeah, we're going to go to the second place and see what we can do. We did catch a hybrid in here, which was pretty neat, and a bunch of fat bass. But we really need that like 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 pounder. So we're going to go hunt for him now. I'll catch you guys at the next lake.
All right, you ready, Fletch?
I'm ready.
8-pounder. No more of that little fish stuff. We got some good. We got some good fish. Oh, oh. Okay, I'm going. I am going. I just want to catch a big one, dude. We've been on a great streak. So, oh my gosh, Fletcher, what are you doing? You're good. What did you do?
The rope was stuck underneath the golf cart wheel. I tried to yank it out and...
You about threw yourself. I like turned it. I thought you were trying to hand me the camera or something.
About went in the water with it. Goodness gracious, man. You know, I'm just struggling.
Yeah, you
this
probably
morning.
Should hand me that.
I'm struggling.
I don't know if I got that on camera. Like, turn around, it's about to go in the water. I'm just gonna go ahead and start casting, dude, because last time I did this, some crazy stuff happened. I'm just gonna whip one while you're doing your thing. Oh, God. Made me fall. Well, guys, we are on the big lake. We haven't been on this side of it in a very long time. And,
good one?
Dude, yeah. No, it's not. Oh, God. Bro, I got too excited. What did I say? I said I'm going to cast because something stupid's going to happen. That's a great sign.
Hey, first cast.
What is going on, dude? I'm, like, weird with those casts like that. Where you, like, right where you're, like, getting your stuff ready? I think that's, like, our good luck charm, dude. I got to always cast when you're getting your stuff ready. And I think that sparks off the day.
At least for you, it does.
Yeah, last episode, I don't know what was going on, dude. I was on a little roll. Well, that's a nice little fish. That's a good sign, bro. They might be biting like a mother in here. And then around that other bend out there, could be good with the crankbait.
Yeah. But I think our most promising spot's going to be out here in the middle.
Yep. Well, even right out here.
Yeah, no, even out here.
Be really good at the mouth of this one.
Get those birds over there.
There he is.
You got one?
Yeah.
You?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Right at the mouth. It's actually a decent one. He's not fighting.
Yeah, he's just coming right in. I barely got him.
That's a good fish, too. A little 2-pounder, it looks like. Fatty. Fatty daddy. Look at that. Dubby guy. Nice. On the crank, right at the mouth. That's what I was thinking. Try it. There he is. That's a good one. I think we should fish around here for a second.
All right. You got it.
God, dog. He hammered that thing, dude. Hammered it. Gosh, guys, I already caught 3. This has been quick. They're biting.
They're biting
good. Eating that crank, dude. Like I said, if they're going to eat it, I'm going to throw it. Don't do it. So let me get you off the hook, buddy. Yeah, nothing big, but pretty fish, man. God, man. Just throwing these cranks. There he is.
Got him?
That might be a better one. No. God, dog. Eating this thing right on that corner. He ate it better than a lot of them. There we go, little guy. There you go. That's a good one. Ain't it?
He's shaking his head like crazy. I can feel those head shakes. Oh, yeah. Big one, net.
Dude, that's your PB. 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 Fletcher. Hey, watch out for my rod. Watch out.
Oh, gosh.
Dude, that's your PB. That's your PB. That's the biggest fish I've ever seen.
Holy smokes. Holy smokes. Get in the net.
No! Dude, that's a giant, bro.
My
that's
gosh.
A freaking giant.
Oh my
god. Dude, that's a giant, bro. Dude, that's a giant. That's a freaking toad.
Dude.
Oh my god, dude. That's a big fish. That's a big one. I thought he was a lot bigger than he actually is, but that is a big fish. Oh my gosh.
That is a monster there, guys. Oh my
god. When I saw him, dude, he's big. Don't get me. That's a big fish.
No.
Like, that's a 7-pounder?
Probably
6, 7-pounder?
High 6 at the least.
Yeah, that's close to 7, dude. When I saw him in the water, I seriously thought he was a 9. Like, the length of him just made him, you know what I mean? It just
Yeah.
It just looked like a 9. Guys, Fletcher just caught him 8. That was a good one, dude. That was a dang good fish.
Got one?
Yeah.
Good one?
I can't tell. It's a lot of weight, but I don't think he's big. I don't know. Yeah, he's not big. Can't be. Yeah.
Oh,
Chugger lugger. Watch them just start annihilating it. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Giant. Giant on the chug bug. Yeah,
is
I'm gonna
like need a 4.5, 5?
Yeah. Oh, looks like a smallmouth.
Goodness gracious.
Yeah, hey, I'm gonna need the net on this one. Bro, why does he look like a smallmouth? Dude, he clobbered that, bro. Clobbered that chug bug. I was just about to say, I've never caught a fish on this bridge, and all of a sudden he just, dude, that was what I was waiting on.
Just
that,
a, just a that,
that hit right there. Yes, 3-pounder, maybe 3.5, if we're lucky. Look at that, she clobbered that chug bug. We got some rain, sorry about the camera's a little fogged up. Been raining on us, so I picked up that chug bug. Threw it around this bridge and that girl clobbered it. I told Fletcher he's gonna be a big in the eat set. And that's a good, that's my best fish.
One.
Best fish today, probably about
you
three.
On the scale?
Three something. I'm gonna guess 3 pounds, 5 ounces. I don't think she's quite 3.5. I think she's just right below it, but it's definitely a 3-pounder. I'll give you that. Oh, 3 pounds, 5 ounces.
Oh, nice.
Guessed her right on the money. Little over 3.25, 3-pound, 5-ounce bass, baby. Let's get it. Oh, this guy's soaked from that. That was smart.